Coming up, a medical certificate requirement for hot air balloons and flying a sleek hot rod.
Plus, solving the mystery of the LA jetpack. And you've got to see how they got this Bonanza video. AOPA Live this week begins in just a moment.
This is AOPA Live this week with Tom Haynes and Alyssa Cobb.
Well, it's one of the biggest challenges facing general aviation. How are we going to get the lead out of our fuel? It's an environmental issue and a public relations problem.
Yeah, it sure is. General aviation is one of the last remaining leaded fuel users. It's a tall order. We need a fuel that's high octane to run high compression engines that can be intermixed with 100 low lead and available at a similar price to what we pay today. The industry has been working on this for years to find a solution. Now we're starting to make some progress. At Oshkosh this year, GAMI announced the first FAA-approved 100-octane unleaded fuel. The fuel was approved using the STC process. That means the FAA needs to approve the fuel for each engine and airframe model, and only a small number of engines and airframes were initially approved. But now the FAA added over 600 engines to the approved model list last week. That's about 70% of the engines in the fleet. The approved airframe list is expected soon. This week, AOPA and other aviation associations also asked Congress to increase funding for the Alternative Fuels for General Aviation program. So, Alyssa, there's a lot of progress going on right now, but still lots to be done in the manufacturing side, refining, distribution challenges. So just know that while we're seeing progress, it's probably 2 years to maybe as many as 5 years before you're going to see this unleaded fuel at your local airport, or at least in most local airports. So plenty yet to do.
That's right. It is a long process for sure. Marathon, not a sprint.
Yeah, absolutely.
The rollout of C-band fifth generation mobile network technology, or 5G, might be delayed to protect aviation safety. C-band 5G has been authorized to go online December 5th. The new transmitters interfere with radar altimeters, according to the RTCA. Now, many airline and helicopter operations depend on radar altimeters, especially in poor weather. AT&T and Verizon so far have pledged to pause the rollout to January, but AOPA and other advocates believe the safety work that needs to be done will take a lot longer than a month. Bringing the new C-band transmitters online could force passenger airlines, helicopters, business jets, and cargo operators to suspend operations in poor weather.
Pilots, aircraft manufacturers, and safety advocates have for the past 5 years asked the FCC to consider such adverse impacts on aviation.
Now, if all 5G providers agree to delay activation until January 5th or later, or if the FCC requires that, it will at least prevent major disruption of holiday travel and package delivery. Now, this is a very nuanced and technical matter, and it's hard to fully explain here. So if you're interested, we have a lot more information on our website, and you can take a deep dive into the issue.
Meanwhile, major changes proposed to the hot air ballooning world. The FAA is expected to issue a notice of proposed rulemaking that would require commercial balloon operators to hold a second-class medical certificate while engaged in any commercial activity. That includes passenger flights, aerial photography, and advertising. For decades, no medical has been needed for ballooning. The move comes in response to a single fatal accident in Texas back in 2016 that killed the pilot and 15 passengers. Pat Cannon is president of the Balloon Federation of America. He says there's never been a recorded incident of medical incapacitation leading to a balloon accident.
Literally none of those have ever been tied to a medical issue. So it means that pilots have been flying with potentially grounding items if they had been an airplane pilot, some serious illnesses of some sort. Those pilots probably flew and flew safely for years and years and years. And now they're going to have to try and draw a second-class medical.
The Balloon Federation of America has been working with its members to educate them about medical issues, but the proposed rule would have a significant impact on the balloon industry.
There may be as many as 1,800 commercial balloon pilots in the country. And that means that 1,800 people in whatever period of time the final rule provides will have to go and apply for a second-class medical, of course, if they wish to do so. In the proposed NPRM, it says that instruction will be exempted from that, which I think is a step in the right direction. because it allows those commercial pilots to continue to teach others to fly.
The proposed rule is expected to be published in the coming weeks. The FAA will seek public comment on the proposal before putting it into regulation.
Well, the FAA hopes to make aviation more inclusive. They're looking at the language used in aviation to see if there's an opportunity for improvement. The feds are hosting a virtual inclusive language summit on November 10th. The hope is to adopt language that is both gender neutral and inclusive. And they want to know what you think. Now, it's going to be streamed live on the FAA Facebook and YouTube pages. You don't need to register in advance. And you'll be able to submit questions and comments during the event. It runs from 10 a.m. until 12:30 Eastern on November 10th. And a big honor for a New York seaplane pilot. Sarah Tamar is the winner of this year's Martha King Scholarship for Female Flight Instructors. The scholarship is donated on behalf of Martha King, who started King Schools with her husband John in 1974. The scholarship is worth over $18,000 and will help Sarah earn her CFI. Now, listen to this. Sarah worked in Manhattan and watched the seaplanes take off and land from her office window, and she was so fascinated that she went for a discovery flight, got a ground job for a seaplane operator, and became hooked on aviation. Now, she flies one of those seaplanes in Manhattan as a pilot for Tailwind Air. And you may remember her from her blog series about flamping, or flying and camping, across America, and also from some of her work on our AOPA website. Congratulations, Sarah.
Yes, congratulations, Sarah. That's great. Hey, there's a big event with a big name that is ushering big things in for high school students. The 2021 AOPA Foundation High School Virtual Aviation STEM Symposium, presented by Boeing. It's November 16th, and it's free to anyone who registers. There's a famous host. Stevie Treisenberg is better known as Plane Girl on TikTok or Bayflight on Instagram, and she's got 1.3 million followers. She'll lead the program that includes video clips from FAA Deputy Administrator Bradley Mims and country superstar Dierks Bentley. There's some great breakout sessions too.
That's going to include representatives of American Airlines, Southwest Airlines, and United Airlines, their airline cadet programs. A lot of people don't realize that organizations like these three actually have high school to flight school programs, and they will be discussing their specific programs and how high school students across the country can apply for and actually get into the pathway to become an airline pilot right out of high school.
You can find everything you need to register at the address on your screen. The program will help just about anyone, from teachers to administrators to students. The AOP High School Aviation STEM program is now in 322 schools across 44 states and serves some 10,000 students in grades 9 through 12. Thanks to generous donations to the AOPA Foundation, it's free to any school that wants it. So hey, hang tight. Next up, we'll talk about this amazing drone video of a Bonanza.
That's right. Then we'll fly the VL-3.
Are you thinking about selling your airplane? I'm Kevin Tracy, and I owned one of the largest advertising agencies north of Boston, and I'm the former VP of marketing at Piper. I know airplanes, and I know advertising. Go to twinairaviation.com to learn more about how I can help you sell your airplane.
Welcome back. It's just about holiday lights flight season, and festive decor might not be the only thing that catches your eye. Laser strikes on aircraft are increasing. The FAA says that more than 7,100 strikes have been reported this year. Now, high-powered lasers can incapacitate pilots. We know it's against the law to shine a laser at an aircraft, and there are laser-blocking glasses that pilots can wear. Now, the FAA wants pilots to report any instances of a laser strike. You can find more on the FAA website.
Hey, we've all seen great air-to-air video, but one pair of social media creators teamed up to show us that you ain't seen nothing yet. AOPA Live's Paul Harrop caught up with record-setting pilot Matt Guthmiller and high-speed drone creator Nico Films in the pilot lounge to talk about how they got these amazing shots.
What has the response been to this? I think it's certainly been a talker piece across social media over the last few days. What are people saying?
I mean, I think that the response universally has been, very positive. People just, are stunned by it. I mean, they almost think it's, something out of Microsoft Flight Simulator or something. You know, it just looks unreal because you never see this kind of shot, around an airplane, or certainly something that's moving as quickly as a Bonanza.
What's it like to shoot with a FPV drone towards a moving target like the airplane?
So airplanes, I mean, the main difficulty and challenge with flying with airplanes is that they're so big and they're so fast, right? So what that creates is quite a bit of turbulence behind it. So there's certain spots that when you're flying with a little FPV drone, you have to avoid. And also, of course, just as far as safety is concerned, I want to make sure that I keep a good distance away from Matt, but to capture the shot.
You can see much more from Nico Films and Matt Guthmiller on their social media and YouTube channels. See the full conversation with them right now on the AOPA Live YouTube channel. Hey, the more public use airport access we have, the better. One way to add airports to the system without building new ones is to improve former and current military airfields for public access. That's the goal of the FAA's military airport program. Three more airports were just added, so now seven airports can receive FAA improvement funds next year. The FAA sees the project as an innovative way to grow airport access using existing airports.
And it might just be the simplest answer after all, a hoax. Over the past few years, there have been numerous reports of a jetpack flying around Southern California skies. From airline captains to people on the ground to CFIs, there's been a number of reported sightings, usually in the LAX Bravo airspace, but actually all around the basin. Well, now officials offer this video. That is a Jack Skellington balloon drifting along over the Hollywood Hills. Could it be the mysterious LA jetpack? Well, the truth is out there.
Some of you may actually get that reference. Could it be the best of all worlds? Fast, capable, and super efficient all in one airplane? The European ultralight regulations allow for designs that we can only dream of here in the U.S. AOPA editor-at-large Dave Hirschman shows us one of them, the JMB aircraft VL-3.
Fast, efficient, modern, exciting. These are some of the words that spring to mind when describing the VL-3 or just about any of the new ultralight airplanes designed and built in Europe.
It's got good useful load, a wide envelope from stall speed to max cruising speed, and very efficient with the retractable gear. Stall speed at 1,500 pounds gross weight is about 52 knots. It's down in the 40s if you get the weight down. This one's certified at 1,500 pounds in the experimental exhibition class. Well, I've had it up to 194 knots at 15,500 feet, and that's maximum cruise at that altitude. And at 5 gallons an hour up high, you can cruise at over 150 knots. JMB bought this aircraft company about 10 years ago, and they've been in existence for about 20 years. The 915 came out about a year ago. This is the first one in the U.S., and they've really taken off. We got four in the U.S. now. This one is 862 pounds, and on 135 horse, at 10 gallons an hour, it'll go 195 knots. That's pretty amazing. You can get the 912, the 914, or the 915. The 912 is 100 horse, the 914 is 115, and it's turbocharged with a carburetor, and the 915 is turbocharged with fuel injection. This aircraft has a G3X. It also has a GN375, which is IFR certified for GPS approaches. It also has a G5, which is a backup for the G3X if it would ever fail. I don't know of any planes on the market that really are as efficient as this plane. You know, you can slow it down and get over 30 miles to the gallon in this plane. It's very well built. It's like a work of art.
European manufacturers are restricted to the same 600 kilogram weight limit as our light sport aircraft category. But other than that, they play by an entirely different set of rules. Their airplanes have retractable landing gear, constant speed propellers, top speeds approaching 200 knots, and outstanding range. Just like the German Autobahn, they impose no speed limits. In contrast, our LSA category prohibits these performance-enhancing features and has a top speed of just 120 knots. The VL-3 by JMB Aircraft is made in the Czech Republic. It can be imported and flown in the United States under the Experimental Exhibition or the Experimental Amateur Built categories. There's also an LSA-compliant version. A great deal of work is now being done to get the FAA to adopt new, less restrictive policies under the upcoming Mosaic rules due next year. If adopted, new policies could give U.S. manufacturers the freedom to do what European firms are already doing, and possibly even more. Dave Hirschman, AOPA Live.
You can read more about it in an upcoming issue of AOPA Pilot Magazine.
Well, and finally this week, Halloween was over the weekend, and we have one costume you just have to see, or be, really. We have all been abuzz about this one. AOPA eMedia production assistant Elizabeth Linares donned a beekeeper suit with airplanes flying through it and went as a Class B airspace. Elizabeth is an instrument-rated private pilot and an apprentice beekeeper. It goes without saying, she's very creative. Well, Tom, Elizabeth is super talented and very creative, as we've seen here, and she's such a joy to work with.
We have absolutely seen that here. She's very creative in everything she brings to the office and other costumes we've seen from her, and even the baking that she does is really creative. So way to go, Elizabeth. And that's it this week. Leave us a comment or let us know what you think.
Or drop us a note. Either way, we'd love to hear from you. See you next time.
Now's your chance to take part in the You Can Fly Challenge. From now until the end of the year, your gift to the AOPA Foundation will be matched. The High School Initiative provides aviation STEM curriculum for students across the country. Flight training helps schools and instructors deliver the kind of experiences that today's pilots demand. Flying Clubs helps to start new clubs and provide support so existing clubs can flourish and grow. Help build a stronger pilot community today by visiting aopafoundation.org/challenge to have your gift doubled.